downtown Brattleboro, and we're with some great musicians tonight. And before they get started, we're going to have a chance to talk about them and how they came together. So Moss and Martin, you've been playing together for about 15 years.
True. We had a band called The Weld a few years ago, and then we were Slim Pickens when we picked up this guy, and now we're Jabbo, because we like the sound of Jabbo. Forgot to tell you that.
And where are you all from?
Originally, I'm from Indiana. Live in Brattleboro.
I live in Windham. I grew up in Brookline, Vermont.
And Martin.
I live in Brattleboro.
And Paul.
I grew up here. This is my hometown.
Okay, great. And we have Moss is on the mandolin tonight, and Martin's going to be joining you later on the mandolin.
That's right.
Okay, great. So I just wanted to talk about what drew you to this instrument and who inspired you to get started in music.
There is a great old blues guy named Yank Rachel that played in Indiana when I was there. And he first recorded in 1929, and he played blues on the mandolin, completely not influenced by bluegrass music at all, which is kind of rare because you don't see too many mandolin players that don't have a bluegrass influence. I saw him in the mid-80s, and I thought that was so cool, so I started playing, and I think my style is kind of bluesy as a result of Yank. I saw him play like 5 or 6 times. There was also, of course, David Grissman. He's the king of the mandolin players. He's influenced both Martin and myself. Sam Bush. And, you know, there's others, but we like the guys that do something other than bluegrass, you know. So
we like bluegrass too.
Yeah, we do.
But it is nice when people can be free to draw from different styles and not just be stuck on one particular thing. So it's kind of like where we're coming from too.
Great. And 15 years is a long time together. So what's kept you two going?
Friendship.
Yeah, friendship and love of music.
Good. So I do want to talk to Paul here for a second. He has a rhythm box, which he actually made himself. And Paul, so I'd like you just to talk about that a little bit. And you said to me that you were a drummer and how you got started with the rhythm box and where it's from and what influenced you and how that all came to be.
Well, my main instrument is drum kit. So I don't know all that much about the history of this, although it's common down in South America, in the Latin countries, Peru and Cuba, and it's called a cajon. So the way I got into this was, I think this is my the first configuration where I'm actually playing this and not playing drums. I bought this materials at Perkins, for $10 and put this thing together. It's got a sound hole in the back. And I just rigged up some snares on the inside off of an old snare drum. And the way it's played is traditionally, I guess, is you use your foot and use your hands. And like this. So it's a lot easier to transport. You don't have to bring your drums around. And so it allows me to play with other musicians in different configurations where it's more of an acoustic setting.
Great. And you guys are doing a lot of acoustic tonight. That's my understanding.
We are going to try to play some two mandolin stuff, I think.
I think
at the very end. Yeah, we're going to play electric most of the time, though.
Okay, great. So let's get started. Anybody else? Colin, you want to say hi to Mom?
Hi, Mom. Mom don't have a TV, so she'll have to hear about it from somebody else.
Okay, great. Live from Brattleboro. And somebody say the name of the band, because I'll get it wrong.
Jabbo. Thank you. J.J. Cale. Got to get that inside air clamp.
All right.
Next on the list. I think we should also mention that maybe we've played together maybe 3-4 times.
Yes.
So
yeah. Maybe.
Well, Colin,
maybe 2 or 3.
That's good for spontaneity's sake.
Yeah. Well, that's how actually when we first started, the three of us before you joined. I was called a couple nights before a gig, a Halloween gig, maybe four and a half years ago, without any rehearsal, and it was like right out on the tight wire, and it was fun. It's been like that ever since.
Should we do James?
Okay, sure.
What's up?
Okay, this is an original song.
Django Squirrel.
It's called Django Squirrel. Thank you. Also partly inspired by the Squirrel Nut Zippers. They had a jam that was kind of similar, but it's definitely our own song, so no copyright infringement.
For all the money we're going to make on it.
Exactly.
Thank you.
drum solo was the best part.
Having a seat, though, right on your set's pretty cool.
From now on, every song has to have a drum solo. In fact, Wipeout. You know Wipeout? Should we try it?
Ooh.
No?
Ooh.
Okay.
How about
next time?
The Israelites.
Yeah, we
can
do
that. What about that Miles Davis number?
Or That's True, too.
All Blues?
Yeah. Anything you want.
Is that the one you're thinking?
Yeah, I think that's the one.
Can we do All Blues, Brian?
Sure.
Thank you.
Miles Davis, of course. I guess, what was the one you mentioned?
Oh, the Israelites.
Oh, yeah. Israelites, Desmond Dekker.
Desmond Dekker, yeah.
Is that good? Of the thing at the library with Eugene Human on Thelonious Monk. It was fantastic. Thank you for that, because I really enjoyed that.
Yeah, I was there. That was great.
And he's one of our heroes, and we're going to do What You Need.
Okay. Thank you.
Okay. We heard NRBQ do it, one of our favorite bands, love NRBQ, and they're reformed now with a new lineup. They're going to be at the Green River Festival. Terry Adams leading the band. And they did this in 1970, I think, on this Ludlow Garage CD, but it's Ross and Roland Kirk. Here comes the whistle, man. Thank you.
What more can you say about that?
What else can you say?
Except Bill wrote it, right?
Oh, yeah. Okay, this is
the Watson it refers to is
yes,
Doc
it's a
Watson.
A collaboration which, between Bill Monroe and Doc Watson.
Just a blues thing, pretty much.
Bill wrote it. Doc came up with the blues riff, so it became the Watson's blues.
Okay.
You guys ready?
Yeah. Thank you.
mandolins. We've got a few minutes left here. We're going to try to play an acoustic song.
Together a couple of times, that's some real fresh sound. So I was highly impressed, and the rhythm box next to the mandolin was pretty amazing, and just a nice group energy, and really appreciated. So thanks. So you're going to take us home with a little bit of acoustic on the mandolin, and
a few minutes, right?
Sorry,
one more song. Okay. I think we're going to do, what do you think, Martin, Last Train?
Yeah.
Okay. The Old Monkey's Tune, Last Train to Clarksville. We have an arrangement of it that we like, so.
Okay, great. And thanks for watching us at Artist a la Mode. We'll be here next month on May 12th, and you can check out our website. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you soon.
Song in D. It's a nice instrumental bluegrass jam.
Thank you.